Hey, Orcs people. All right. Here's how not to condition your horse to gunfire. This was posted on YouTube. Use it under Fair Use Act. Not claiming any copyrights. Stupid Facebook popping up things. Look. Boys will be boys. These guys are out here doing things with horses. I don't agree with it. It's not to say when I was younger, if I was out there, I would have done the same stupid thing. So stupid things are done with horses. But remember, a horse hears, like a dog. They've got big directional ears, and they hear everything very high-pitched. And the reason why people use earplugs at gun ranges is because a bullet hurts the ears. It causes ringing in your ears. When you have ringing in your ears, permanent ear damage has occurred. Now, how long that ringing lasts depends on how young you are and how much damage was occurred. Sometimes the ringing will only last a few seconds. Sometimes it'll last a minute. Sometimes it'll last an hour. Then as you get older, my age, you got ringing in your ears all the damn time, and it's a pain in the butt. But horses' ears are extremely sensitive. So to ambush a horse like this, it's really unfair to the horse. This is a young horse. This is a very, very bad lesson. Although you hear a lot of hooting and hollering and laughing, this is not a good lesson for the horse. It ambushes a horse. When I talk about ambushing, I talk about not setting the horse up to succeed, setting a horse up to fail, trying something without knowing what the results are. Instead of taking small steps, the proper way to get a gunfire, they should have fired this gun at 50 feet away, 60 feet away, reassured a horse, have someone else shoot it, maybe come closer, get closer a few times, maybe do some firecrackers, maybe do some whips cracking, maybe do a lot of things where the horse kind of gets used to it, just like thunder. Horses don't do this when thunder and lightning strikes, because they get used to it. It doesn't scare the crap out of them out of ambush when they got somebody on their back. They're out there for a nice relaxing ride. They're looking around at the horses, and all of a sudden a freaking explosion goes off in their ear. What do you expect the horse to do? So here is the video of how not to break a horse in or get a horse used to gunfire. Actually, this is a perfect video on how to make a horse scared of gunfire, how to teach the horse to be afraid, and we'll play it. This horse is really scared. It looks fun. He doesn't know what's going on. He went into flight and fear mode. He doesn't hear. He's feeling pain from a bit. He's still scared. His saddle's probably twisted off of him. He's panicked. He's got no reassurance. He's being yanked by a guy with a bit. Being put in. A dog's running in. There's another horse. See, he almost ran in that horse from that blind run. That's kind of, okay, you hear the other horses kind of getting jacked up. Now, this guy right here is probably smart. They're telling him to grab him. He doesn't grab him, which is a smart move. Because if he grabbed that horse, he would just make it worse, get pulled off. Let the horse run out, kind of get his mind and slow down. Chasing him and doing all that. Pretty sad situation. I'll mute it this time. He's going to hold the gun up. I'll try to zoom in on the guy. Watch the horse's expression when he... Man, poor horse. He's scared to death. Now he's got a guy pulling on his mouth. Horse is not being mean. He's not being bad, but he learned some really bad lessons. He learned to buck when I get scared and I can get this guy off of me. He learned to run away when I get scared and I can get free. He learned that if I buck and get the guy off of me, I can run home and I don't have something blowing up in my ear. He learned a lot of bad lessons here. Really, really feel sorry for the horse. These guys didn't mean to be mean. They're not being bad people. They're just being silly, trying something with a horse. And, sometimes you may get a horse that would have handled it a lot better. But most horses, especially a young, inexperienced horse, out for new rides, you blow something up behind his head where he can't see it right in his freaking ear, And I'm just not sure what kind of reaction you're going to expect. Did you really expect a horse to go, no big deal, that's just a gun? I mean, what reaction would you really expect from this? I'll play it one more time with the sound, and I'll shut up. You just
go.
I'm not sure what else to say on this. It is what it is. It happened. Is the horse ruined? No. You know, he's probably got ringing in his ears. He may have lost some of his hearing in his ear. I mean, those people who care about their horses and do those shotgun shooting, they put earplugs in their ears. I mean, it's just, their ears are more sensitive than ours, and we're shooting them from a blind side behind. What do you expect a human would do if you walk up behind them and go, watch this, I'll walk up behind somebody and not tell them and fire a gun? You think they're going to react, drop to the ground, run, grab their ears, maybe turn around, swing? I mean, what kind of reaction would you expect from this? All right, no sense in beating a dead horse or a deaf horse, because the poor thing is, the lesson's done, and now you got to undo it. And can it be undone? Sure. You can screw a horse up fast. You can fix him fast. So we'll end that there. And I don't know what else to say. I just feel sorry for young horses that have to learn these bad lessons through no fault of their own. And they have to live with the consequences. Now the next time when his horse throws somebody, or a branch breaks, or somebody's hat falls off, or somebody steps on a sack on the ground that pops, or somebody opens a can of Coke and it goes, and the horse freaks out and starts bucking, they're going to be saying, this horse is crazy, he needs to be put down. That's why I don't like bad lessons. That's why I think horses that get up to sale, that's why when people write me and go, I tried to fix my horse, and I don't know what I'm doing, but I tried this, this, and this, and the horse threw me four times. Can you help me? No, you've already reinforced that you're an idiot, and you've shown a horse what to do. The more you reinforce this, if they do this a second time, you know, and a third time and a fourth time, the horse wins the same way and it results the same. You just teach the horse bad lessons, and you give them a label of a past with no future, because nobody's going to want a horse that's, hey man, the horse is good except for some reason he freaks out when he hears a bang. So, all right, we'll end that there.